Hello dear students, we have completed with the explanation of chapter computer system. Now let us start with the exercise part of this chapter. Our first question of exercise is tick the correct answer, and this you have to complete in your book. No need of writing this question in your notebook. You have to make an interleave copy or a ruled copy for computer science. So our first question is, a collection of unorganized facts, figures and statistics related to an object are called as, what we call it as, storage, information or data. And the answer is data. Now the next question. This device holds data and instructions for future use, an input device, monitor or storage device. And the answer is a storage device. Now the next question. Any part of computer you can touch and feel is called as a hardware. Next one is, a person who communicates with a computer or uses the information it generates is called, what we call it, him as, user, operator or programmer. And the correct answer is a user. Now next one is, the main part of the computer that is used to process data is called hard disk, keyboard or CPU. And this is also very easy. The answer is CPU. So this was the first question. Take the correct answer. Now the fill in the blanks part. So our first fill in the blank is, dash is an electronic machine that works under instructions given by you. And the correct answer is, what is the correct answer? It is computer. Now the next one is, dash is the collection of unorganized facts which can include words, numbers and images. And the correct answer is data. Data is collection of unorganized facts and figures. Now the main job of computer is to process dash into dash. What will be the answer? The answer will be, it processes data into information. Now the next question. Dash keyboard includes features as alternative key layout and palm rest. And we have studied that ergonomic keyboards. Ergonomic keyboards include these features. Now dash is a rapidity stress injury. Can you name a rapidity stress injury? It is carpal tunnel syndrome. The answer is carpal tunnel syndrome. Carpal tunnel syndrome is a rapidity stress injury. Now next is, answer the following questions. So the first question is, write any five characteristics of a computer, A part. Question number 3, A part is, write any five characteristics of a computer. Question number 3, you have to complete in your notebooks. Fill-ups you can do in the book. No need of writing fill-ups in your notebooks. So the five characteristics, you have to go to page number 4. And the different characteristics of a computer are, this is your answer A. I have highlighted the text that you have to mark in your book, and then you can write in your notebook. First is speed. Computer allows you to perform any task very fast. It can process a large amount of data very quickly. The second characteristic is quality. The computer enables you to create high quality documents and drawings. Reliability. Computers are reliable and accurate, and a computer never makes a mistake by itself. Storage capability. Computers can store enormous amount of data and make this data available for processing at any point of time when it is required or needed. Fifth is versatility. The computer can perform repetitive jobs efficiently. Since in the question, only five characteristics have been asked, so no need of writing more. You can write any five. You can write consistency also. You can write communications also. You can write increased productivity, decision making, computers, help in faster communication, help in sharing information, and they are environment friendly. So you can write any five out of these. Now, the next question, B part. The question is, what are the benefits of using a computer? So we have to write the benefits, and it is also on, I think, page number 5. This is page number 6. So the different benefits are, you have to just write point wise, create, you can create documents, check your finances, perform research, work with numbers, schedule your time, helps in teaching, learning, chatting. You can chat on a computer, buy and sell, play media, play games. So these are the different benefits of a computer. Now, the C part of question number 3. And the question, the C part is explain hardware and humanware. So for this, we have to move to page number 9. And the answer is, hardware is the part of computer that we can touch or feel is called the hardware. For example, mouse, keyboard, monitor, etc. While humanware refers to the person who program, design or operate a computer. So this was the answer C, explain hardware and humanware. Now the next question. The D part, why should you take care of computer? So again we have to move to page number 9. I think page number 7. And the answer is, we should take care of our computer. And the first point is, it keeps your computer healthy, wealthy and wise. Taking care of your computer can keep your computer healthy, wealthy and wise. That is, it makes your computer faster, long lasting and give optimal performance. And second point of the same answer is to avoid expensive repairs. So this is the answer. Why should we take care of our computer? First, it can keep your computer or our computer healthy, wealthy and wise. That is, make the computer faster, long lasting and give optimal performance. And second point is to avoid expensive repairs. These are the two points. Now, the next is E part is, what you mean by ergonomics? Page number 9. And the answer is, ergonomics is the study of people, their physical characteristics and the way in which they function in relation to their working environment, the furnishings and machines they use. This is the answer of the question, what do you mean by ergonomics, E part. Now the next question and the last part of question number 3, what points will you keep in mind for taking care of yourself while using a computer? So we have to go to page number 10. And the answer is, while working on computers for long hours, we should follow these healthy habits. First point is, you should go for a short walk at least once every hour. Second, you should go back to work only after splashing cold water on face. And rinsing your eyes. Third point, you should take breaks often and look at colors and visuals that do not strain the eyes. And fourth, you should stand up, walk up to your window, and then look at trees at a distance and objects at different distances so that the focusing of eyes get some exercise. So this was question number 3. You have to write this question, these questions in your notebook. Now the fourth question. Now the fourth question, which is an application based question. Vaibhav has unknowingly touched his monitor while eating bread and butter. Can you help him remove the butter stains from the monitor? So we know that for cleaning a monitor, we can use a cleaning spray if it is a CRT type of monitor. But if it is an LCD, we just have to clean it with a dry cloth. And if the because butter is there and it will not be removed without using a cleaning spray, so what can we do? We can put the cleaning spray on the cloth and then wipe to remove butter. So what will be our answer? You have to write, Vaibhav can put the cleaning spray on the cloth and then wipe his monitor to remove butter stains. So this was all about the answers of our question, first chapter. Write question number 3 and 4 in your notebooks, and rest of the questions, question number 1 and question number 2, in your book with a pencil. Be very careful while writing. Okay, student. Thank you, students.